Okay guys, in this video we will be seeing how to insert the data to the selected columns only. How to insert data to the selected columns in a record. So here we have three columns for person table: ID column, first name column, and age column. I want to insert only for two columns. Even though we have three columns, I wanted to insert the values for two columns. How we can do that? Insert into person, observe directly I'm specifying the column name, that is ID I wanted to insert and first name as well. First name ID comma first name, these are the two columns that I wanted to insert the value to. Even though we have three columns, I wanted to insert the values for these two columns. While a record is creating, I will be supplying the value for only these two columns, ID and first name. I'm not supplying the value for age column. And now how we can supply the value? Insert into person, and we are specifying the column names, that is ID comma first name, and what are the values we are supplying? Is 8 comma within single quote Murali. Close the bracket with a semicolon. Observe here, if it is for all the columns, we can just say insert into person and values, insert into person values, then within the bracket we can specify the values for all the columns by using a comma as a separator, by keeping comma as a separator. But what if in case I want to supply the values for only selected columns, then this is the syntax: insert into person, we are specifying the column names for which column I'm about to supply the data, and we are supplying the values accordingly, in this case 8 comma Murali. 8 is a number type. Then first name, that is of type varchar2, that is why I'm keeping it in the single quote. Varchar2, we need to supply within a single quote. By using this data, what we have specified and what we are supplied, database will be creating a record for this person table. How to execute this query? Go to the end of this query and just enter. Just press Control plus Enter. Before that, you need to clear the screen. You can just press Control Shift D, or you can just click on this icon. I'll just say Control Shift D. Control Shift D. Need to click on this script output, right? Then you need to press Control Shift T to clear this script output window. So it is copied once again in the set one SQL, the query. Can just remove it and go to the end of the query, press Control Enter to see the query result. One row inserted. We are getting the output in the script output that one row has been successfully inserted. Check out in the Database Explorer, that is by going to this Person tab. Refresh by clicking on this symbol or just pressing Control R. What we are getting as the 8th record, that is in the ID column we have supplied 8, in the first name column we have supplied Murli as the value, and for age we are getting null, right? For the age column we are getting the null. For age column we are not providing a value. In that case, by default null will be inserted. If I don't provide the value for any column, that column will be stored with the null value. The database will be supplying the null value to that column for which we have not supplied the value. In this case, I have not supplied the value for H column. So null will be supplied by the database. So this is the simple example of how we can insert the data to the selected columns only, and what is the result we will be getting in the database, that is the column whichever we have not supplied the value, that column will be getting the null by default. Okay, this is it for this video. Thank you.